What's up everybody, back again with another reaction. Next up I've got the 10 weird gaming stories of February 2017 from the channel Game Ranks, and I'll leave the link to the original video in the description below. So let's get it.
Every month we have bizarre stories fly across our dashboards and timelines, and here at Game Ranks we collect them up and give you the best ones back.
I'm Falcon, and today on Game Ranks it's the 10 weirdest gaming stories from February 2017.
Number 10, some modders put New South Wales police officers into Grand Theft Auto, and that did not make the New South Wales people very happy. The state police minister condemned the online video game that allows New South Wales police officers to be shot, run over, and kill. From the looks of it, though, you play as them, so it's not just allowing them to be shot, run over, and killed. It's also allowing them to shoot people, run over people, and kill other people. Like, I wouldn't say that it's explicitly for any purpose other than probably people from New South Wales thinking it would be cool if they were in this, but you know, people complaining about video games never seem to amount to anything more than, oh my god, the violence. Number 9, exactly. Denuvo, the creators of, well, everybody's favorite thing out there, some notoriously tough digital rights management tools, had a massive log file leak that includes a lot of consumer complaints and a lot of developer complaints that I think is pretty important to note. Now, seeing as the Resident Evil 7 protection was cracked and that whole shindig went down, this probably caused them to get a little bit on the sweaty side. Their excuse for the Resident Evil 7 crack was that the main goal of DRM is keeping the game safe during the initial sales window, taking it and trying to say that it's only supposed to work for like 3 or 4 days. John Carmack, who is the CTO for Oculus, said that he just wanted to shout very loudly, "You lie!" at ZeniMax for claiming they had stolen trade secrets. He posted a long Facebook post about ZeniMax at the trial that they were, you know, trying to prove one way or the other. He said that ZeniMax ignored the measures of code similarity that can be quoted and the edit distance between abstract syntax trees, but it did come out essentially that some actual copyrighted code had been used. One of the Oculus programmers admitted to some code being copied and pasted into the Oculus SDK, but did not say that they had infringed on quote-unquote trade secrets. Become pretty contentious, and frankly, the verbiage they're using to describe everything, I don't understand. Number 7, a decade-old Team Fortress 2 bug has finally been fixed. It was literally one line of code that caused hitboxes to get incredibly out of sync with the actual models, and in some cases, this could even be interpreted as somebody cheating, but nobody was actually cheating, it's just a really bad bug. If you've ever wondered why you shot somebody and you're like, that should have hit the hitbox, but it didn't, now you know. The bug was actually discovered by a mod developer last month by the name of Sigsieve, with 2 underscores after his name. Valve finally decided to fix it and pushed it out on February 14th, Valentine's Day update, but no, it did not include any sort of Valentine-y oriented. It's just a bug fix. Number 6, wow. Billionaire Elon Musk posted a photo of an underground tunnel beneath Washington, D.C. I'm assuming he was walking through it. It is possibly one of the coolest photos I've seen in a long time. Somebody replied to him saying it looks like something you'd see Gordon Freeman crawling through, and Elon replied, "That's exactly what I thought. I love Half-Life." And suddenly a lot of things make sense, in my opinion. A lot of the design aesthetics, the logos, even the names of his company, SpaceX, Tesla Motors, seem a little obvious and silly in a way that the Half-Life universe tends to also be. Number 5, a Russian man was convicted of murder after killing a friend, and I'm sorry to laugh, but killing a friend over an AMD versus Nvidia argument. And this, my friends, is something that you need to sit down and say, it's not worth it. I don't care how much you like one brand of video card over another brand of video card. Don't stab your friend because they like the other graphics card brand. Oh my god, I wish I never had to say that, actually. You need to start understanding that this stuff doesn't matter on that level. Brand loyalty is a bad thing, and this is your proof. Number 4, Gabe Newell of Valve, Half-Life, and all that fame did a Rare interview, and a lot of people are very optimistic about VR, including him. He thinks VR is doing great in every way consistent with their expectations, and
then he said, we're also comfortable with the idea that it will turn out to be a complete failure. Now, I do think VR is a bit of a gimmick, and that seems to kind of be the thing that's still holding it back, despite very high-profile launches in the last year, that and the price. But I will say, I'm kind of happy to hear something like that out of him, because it shows he's doing it because he wants to do it, and not because he wants to make money. Passion goes a long way in my book. Salute to you, Mr. Newell. Number three, G2A has a flaw in their system. It's a bit complex. It involves listing fake sales, which a user pointed out to G2A and wasn't taken very seriously. So in order to prove their point, they listed a fake game and got banned off of G2A's service for it. That's not good PR, G2A, and that's not how people should do business. Number two, getting banned from Disney's social network Club Penguin is now a speedrun competition. Yes, the people are streaming how quickly they can get banned from Club Penguin.
What?
Now, more of this competition takes place outside the app than inside, as registering counts as part of it. So you have to do a very quick register, get in, and curse. Curse like a sailor, get banned immediately. The reason why? Because why not? Disney's closing down Club Penguin at the end of March, so yeah, I think that's a great idea. The current record stands at 39 seconds. You think you can beat that, gamers? And finally, number one in garbage people news from around the world. Over in Australia, some thieves stole a bolted down PlayStation from a children's cancer ward at a hospital. Are you joking?
That's
like kids
messed up.
That spend their time around that thing every day because they're dying of cancer, and they would play it while they're taking 3-hour chemotherapy to try not to die. I mean, that's so unbelievably crass. I just can't. I have nothing to say about it in a joking manner. That's just terrible. Whoever did that, just fuck off. Like, fall off of a bridge, please. But
dude,
not before you
get
that
his
PlayStation
ass
back. Thanks. Ugh, that last one leaves a bad taste, doesn't it? Dude, see anything weird this month involving gaming? Or you just want to tut-tut that horrible person from the last story? Let's meet in the comments. I'm interested to hear what you have to say. If you enjoyed this video, please click like. And if you're not subscribed, now is the time to do it. We upload brand new videos every day of the week. The best way to see them first is, of course, a subscription. We thank you very much for watching this video. I'm Falcon. You can follow me on Twitter at FalconTheHero. And we'll see you next time right here on GameRanks.
Yeah, that last one, that dude needs to get, I don't know, he needs to get thrown in jail. That's extremely messed up. So, but anyways, leave a comment down below. Let me know what y'all thought. And if you liked this video, remember to like and subscribe. Thanks.